In this segment, I'm going to explore the differences between treatment, management, and prevention in relation to several common forms of dementia, as well as present a person-centered approach to caring for someone living with dementia. Our American culture has a fixation on treatment and cure, sort of a 1-2 punch that we've come to expect. Got symptoms, get cure. To this end, when's the last time you walked down the aisles of a pharmacy? When I was a kid, the local pharmacy had maybe one small aisle with over-the-counter medications and remedies, including such items as aspirin, Pepto-Bismol, Alka-Seltzer, Vicks Vapor Rub, and maybe Epsom salt. Today, you can walk through aisle after aisle of over-the-counter products designed to address every possible symptom and ailment. Confusing, isn't it? Yet this is a very tangible sign of our cultural fixation on treatment and cure. Sure, potentially reversible forms of dementia, like those caused by infection or depression, may respond to treatment and be cured. But the most common forms of dementia, like Alzheimer's disease and vascular dementia, are irreversible and progressive, and so far there are no known cures and very limited treatment options. It is this reason why many people find it so difficult to accept the diagnosis of a progressive irreversible dementia, such as Alzheimer's disease. We're so accustomed to treatment and cure in the form of a pill, surgery, or therapy, that accepting the disease that has no hope of cure through treatment is almost unimaginable. That's why, for these forms of progressive irreversible dementia, we need to shift the focus from that of treatment and cure to that of prevention and management. Prevention is defined as the action of stopping something from happening or arising. Therefore, prevention involves a proactive approach where the caregiver anticipates and addresses the potential needs of the person they care for with dementia, and as a result, stop potential negative consequences from arising. In regard to caring for persons with irreversible and progressive forms of dementia, such as Alzheimer's disease and vascular dementia, just like prevention, the term management has special meaning. A management focus involves a holistic approach to addressing the needs and issues of the person with dementia. Like prevention, successful management also requires a proactive approach where caregivers of those living with dementia maintain a positive attitude, educate themselves on the particular disease and its clinical course, as well as available community resources, and understand and employ proper communication styles and approaches. Successful dementia care management involves recognizing and addressing a decline in physical or emotional health. And in the case of changes in behavior or challenging behaviors, we need to recognize these as a form of communication stemming from an unmet need or needs. In these cases, the effective caregiver must also be like a detective, able to analyze the situation, identify potential unmet needs, then develop and implement a plan to successfully address these needs. This is not generally something where a one-size-fits-all solution will work, nor is it a single solution. It's an ongoing search for clues followed by a series of trial and error. The concept of behavior management will be covered in much greater depth in the next video in this series. Next, I'd like to introduce you to the concept of person-centered care. Both prevention and management play an important role in person-centered care. According to the Alzheimer's Association, a person-centered care approach aims to see the person with dementia as an individual rather than focusing on their illness or on abilities they may have lost. Instead of treating the person as a collection of symptoms and behaviors to be controlled, person-centered care considers the whole person, taking into account each individual's unique qualities, abilities and interests, preferences and needs. Person-centered care also means treating those living with dementia with dignity and respect. In person-centered care, the words we use matter. The words we use to describe someone or something communicate a lot about who we are and what we believe. Therefore, it's important to take some time to really examine the terms we choose, especially when we're communicating with or about people with dementia. Think about the differences between these two ways of describing someone, as either a dementia patient or as a person living with dementia. The first term, dementia patient, defines a person first and foremost by a set of symptoms, including memory loss. It ignores the fact that the person has lived a life full of accomplishments, experiences, and adventures, and that he or she is still a whole person, capable of contributing to the world. In effect, the term dementia patient replaces the person's individual identity with the identity of a diseased patient. The second term, however, person living with dementia, acknowledges that the individual is alive, is living. Of course, the person has a debilitating condition, but this much more accurate phrase acknowledges that he or she is still a person with an identity outside of dementia. The difference between these terms may at first seem small, but the distinction is important because the way we refer to people affects the way that we relate to and treat them. I look forward to exploring this subject more deeply with you in the next video in this series. Until next time, I'm Mike Faber.